Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. We are delighted to welcome you to the 8th International Tourism Studies Association ITSA Biennial Conference 2020. With delegates 16 countries, the 2020 conference theme is Culture, People, and Technology, the Driving Forces for Tourism Cities. Hosted in the capital city of Indonesia, Jakarta, organized by Universitas Pancasila, and co-hosted by James Cook University, Singapore. Due to the current situation, the conference is held in hybrid format. On-site event in Jakarta is attended by limited participants and following all the official requirement and health protocols with care to ensure safe and enjoyable conference. Ladies and gentlemen, it's an honor for me to introduce and welcome our distinguished guests. The Honorable Mrs. Giri Adiani, Secretary of Ministry of Tourism and Creative Economy, Republic of Indonesia. The Honorable Professor Wahono Sumaryono, Rector of Universitas Pancasila. The Honorable Professor Editut Hendratno, Universitas Pancasila Foundation. Our distinguished keynote speakers, Professor Alastair Morrison, Mrs. Hera Octadiana, PhD, Professor Brian King, and Professor Iis Tushadia. And also we welcome our guest, Vice Rector of Academic from Bunda Mulia University, Mrs. Kandi Sofia Senatri Dahlan, PhD. Representing Hildikti Pari, Dr. Dina Mutiara Lemi. For a brief moment, we would like to invite you to rise and sing Indonesian anthem, Indonesia Raya. Offline participants, may we all rise. Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, we now have a rare opportunity to witness the presentation of traditional dance called Tari Kreasi Topeng Betawi, performed by Sanggar Nusa Budaya. The dance is originated from Betawi, Jakarta. Tell us about Betawi lady who has martial arts ability and have a courage to face different challenge in life. This dance is also reflected today's spirit in wearing a mask as one of the protection that we have to do during the current pandemic, when at the same time, we still have to be productively creative as well as attractive in our way of life. Please welcome Tari Kreasi Topeng Betawi. Thank you. Excellencies, our distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, we are now going to listen to welcome speech delivered by Rector of Universitas Pancasila. Please welcome Professor Wahono Sumaryono.
His Excellency, Minister of Tourism and Creative Economy, Mr. Wisnutama Kusubandio, Vice Representative by the General Secretary of the Ministry, Madam Niwayan Giri Adnyani, distinguished, invited speakers, the Honorable ITSA President Professor Shinran Leto, and all ITSA's Executive Board, the Honorable Campus Dean of James Cook University Singapore, Professor Abhishek Bhatti, the Honorable Rector of Universitas Bunda Mulia, Dodi Surya Bayuaji, represented by the Vice Rector, Madam Kandi Sofia PhD, the Chairman of Association of Indonesian Tourism Tertiary Education Institution, or Hiljikti Pari, represented by the Secretary General, Dr. Diana Leni, the Chairman of Indonesian Tourism Expert Association, or ICTI, Professor Asel Asari, Honorable Chairman of the Foundation of Indonesia Pancasila, Professor Edutut Indratno, the Organizing Committee and all conference delegates, distinguished professors and beloved students. A very good morning to all of you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Om Swastiastu, Namo Buddhaya, Shalom, Salam Kebajikan. First of all, welcome to the 8th ITSA Biennial Conference. We greatly appreciate your participation in this hybrid conference. Your presence reflects the importance of the conference in the context of the development of tourism, tourism education and research, especially in the theme that is very relevant to our university's long presence in Jakarta, the capital of Indonesia. Culture, people, and technology are the driving forces of tourism cities such as Jakarta. Hence, the University of Pancasila, through its Faculty of Tourism and seven other faculties and graduate school, is striving to contribute to the development of tourism that will result in the socio-economic development and community well-being. We are honored to have the opportunity to host the 8th ITSA conference and grateful for the trust and confidence that is given to us by ITSA's stakeholders. As our university reaches its 44th year of the existence this year, we embrace every opportunity to expand our international networks. Our journey in ITSA Conference 2020 has gone a long way from participating in the bidding in 2018, establishing the original date, which was actually in August 2020, and finally, a decision to postpone and hold this conference as a hybrid conference due to the COVID-19 pandemic. I have been following closely on the hard work and perseverance shown by the organizing committee from our Faculty of Tourism, which have reached the peak today in this hybrid conference. The conference delegates come from more than 16 countries, some of them with significant time differences. Therefore, the organizing committee has worked very hard in ensuring that every participant can participate actively in this event. As an academic conference, sharing of ideas, discussion, and networking are the utmost important. Hence, I encourage you to utilize all platforms that are available to harness new ideas and collaboration opportunities. We also hope that you can still feel Indonesian hospitality throughout this hybrid conference and the diversity of our culture through the cultural performance made possible by the support of the Ministry of Tourism and Creative Economy. We believe that tourism is one of the first sectors that to revive after the pandemic. Since more than 9 months, we are quite long enough working from home, and when the time comes, we are waiting for you to visit our wonderful Indonesia. On behalf of Universitas Pancasila, I would like to give our sincere appreciation to the Ministry of Tourism and Creative Economy of Republic of Indonesia, Universitas Pancasila Foundation, James Cook University Singapore, Universitas Bunda Mulia, and the Academy Pariwisata Bunda Mulia, and also Venue Magazine for their great support to this conference. I would like to thank all invited speakers, participants, and our great applause to the organizing committee and all parties involved, which define the success of this event. Congratulations to all of you and enjoy the conference. Thank you very much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Professor Wahono, for the warm welcoming speech. Next, we are turning our attention to the welcome speech from Universitas Pancasila Foundation, Professor Edi Tut Hendratno.
Her Excellency, General Secretary to the Minister of Tourism and Creative Economy, Ibu Niwayan Giri Adnyani, distinguished invited speakers, the Honorable ITSA President, Professor Sinran Leto, and all ITSA's executive boards, the Honorable Campus Dean of James Cook University, Singapore, Professor Abhishek Bhatti, the Honorable Rector of University Bunda Mulia, Bapak Dodi Surya Bayuaji MBA, and Director of Academy Pariwisata Subunda Mulia, Bapak Hanto Joko Susanto MBA, the Chairman of Association of Industry Indonesian Tourism Tertiary Education Institution or Hildik Tiri Pari, Bapak Dr. Suhendro Yono, and the Secretary General Dr. Dina Lemi, the Chairman of Indonesian Tourism Expert Association or ICPI, Professor Azril Azari, the Rector University of Pancasila, the Vice Rector, the Deans, Organizing Committee, and all conference delegates, distinguished professors, and beloved students, a very good morning to all of you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Om Swastiastu. Namo Buddhaya. Shalom, salam kebajikan. On behalf of the University Pancasila Foundation, as the chairman of the Board of Executives, I would like to welcome you to the 8th International Tourism Studies Association Conference. Universitas Pancasila was its per 28, 1966. Currently, we have 7 faculties and 1 graduate school with a student body of around 40,000 students. The Faculty of Tourism is our youngest faculty, which was formed in 2008, but has demonstrated its excellence proven by the achievement of outstanding accreditation. Through the organization of this conference, we are hoping to strengthen and to widen our international network and future collaboration. This conference would not be possible without the hard work and support of many parties involved. Thus, I would like to congratulate the Rector of the University of Pancasila, Professor Dr. Wahono Sumaryono, and the Dean of the Faculty of Tourism, Dr. Devi Kausar, for their leadership and all organizing committee. We have worked tirelessly in this event. Many thanks also goes to honorable keynote speakers, Professor Alistair Marison, Professor Brian King, Professor Iis Tusiadis, and Dr. Hera Okta Diana, who joined us from Shanghai, Hong Kong, and United Kingdom and Australia. I would like also to thank the Ministry of Tourism and Creative Economy for the generous support. Appreciation is also extended to James Cook University Singapore as co-host, University Bunda Mulia and Akademi Pariwisata Bunda Mulia as associate university, and many other parties who I cannot mention one by one. For all conference delegates and presenters, we thank you for your participation and willingness in share your research. For students attending this event, please use this opportunity to learn post-academic tourism, post-pandemic tourism need you ideas, and now is the best time to prepare yourself. Again, congratulations to all of and hope you will have a fruitful conference. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Professor Edi Tut. Our next distinguished guest to share the opening remarks are from the Vice Minister of Tourism and Creative Economy Republic of Indonesia, Mrs. Angela Tanu Sudibyo.
Thank you, Honorable Professor Wahono Sumaryono, Rector of Universitas Pancasila, Honorable Speakers, Distinguished Delegates and Participants, Organizing Committee, Ladies and Gentlemen. A very good morning to all of you. Selamat pagi. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Om Swastiastu, Namo Buddhaya, Salam, Salam Kebajikan. On behalf of the Minister of Tourism and Creative Economy, I would like to deliver his speech on this morning. First and foremost, I would like to start the remarks by thanking God for the grace so we can meet today in good health. It is also my wish that you and your beloved ones at home are safe and in very good health conditions. I would like to thank and then congratulate the committee for organizing this 8th International Tourism Studies Association Biennial Conference 2020. If it is not pandemic, I would be very happy to welcome all of the delegates in a wonderful Jakarta, Indonesia. Despite the unprecedented situations that force us to do this event virtually, I'm sure that the positive energy and the message will pass on between us. Distinguished speakers, participants, ladies and gentlemen, my understanding that the theme of the conference is culture, people, and technology, the driving force for tourism cities. On this remark, I would like to address the current situations because of the pandemic and also to share with you the government responses to cope with the crisis. As we understand that tourism as one of the first sectors to be deeply impacted by the coronavirus pandemic and being one of the last to recover because of the ongoing travel restrictions and the looming global recession. This has consequences beyond the tourism economy, with the many other sectors that support and are supported by the tourism also significantly impacted. World Tourism Organization now foresees a decline of international arrival close to 70%, with recovery to the pre-crisis levels expected to take up to 4 years. On the other hand, OECD, Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, in its recent report, estimates that international tourism will fall by around 80% in 2020. Ladies and gentlemen, the tourism industry across Indonesia archipelago experiences the consequences of the travel restriction and unexpected outbreak of coronavirus. The recent statistic publication by Central Bureau of Statistics, the Republic of Indonesia, reported that in October 2020, Indonesia displays a decrease of 88.25% in terms of its inbound tourist arrival compared to October 2019. Moreover, from January to October 2020, the number of inbound tourists visiting Indonesia only reached 3.72 million arrivals, meaning there's a decrease of 72.35%. Compared to the same period in 2019. This condition brings Indonesia will have the potential loss of its foreign exchange up to $460 billion, and about 100 million tourism workers are at risk of losing their job. Distinguished speakers, delegates, and ladies and gentlemen, it is important for the Indonesia government to take proper measure to respond to the condition right now. On this opportunity, I would like to share this. The Ministry of Tourism and Creative Economy has taken punctual and impressive action to prepare the tourism recovery plans. Some of our current key priority programs are the first one, restoring traveler confidence and supporting tourism businesses. This initiative is mainly to support the industry to adapt and to survive by promoting the implementation of health protocol program that we call CHSE program. CHSE stands for cleanliness, health, safety, and environment sustainability. The next one that we call strengthening supply. It consists of 6 steps. These are preparing the readiness of tourism destination, building a competitive connectivity infrastructure, enhancing tourist attraction, implementing and monitoring the THSE programs, and then capacity building for human resources, and improving quality and quantity of creative economic products. The next one, the program at aiming maintaining demand or market. It is crucial for us to understand the upcoming trend and preference of traveling due to this pandemic. This implies that a deep customers' desire to travel to Indonesia. We are trying to keep Indonesia's nation is always in top of customers' mind. Some of the new trends from our records are that tourists tend to travel to short and medium haul without transit. And then also implementation of health protocol is a must at destination. Tourists also tend to travel in small groups or individual travel. The next of our program is for gaining confidence and building trust of the market by launching a campaign that we call Indonesia Care. Indonesia Care aims to ensure that all protocols has been implemented along with the customer's journey in Indonesia. Indonesia Care is that tourism establishment has applied cleanliness, health, safety, and environmental sustainability. It has also aims to maintain the collective enthusiasm of Indonesia people to care for others' well-being, commitment to care wholeheartedly and meticulous quality to provide cleanliness and hygiene and contactless practice for safety of others. Distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, the crisis has forced us to rethink tourism for the future in order to build a stronger, more sustainable, and resilient tourism industry. Before the pandemic, Indonesia tourism already shifted the national strategy from the quantity to quality tourism. Through quality tourism, the value-added tourism is our main target. Quality tourism also to ensure the implementation of sustainable tourism in each destination. Therefore, the government continues to improve the readiness of our destination, industry, and also manpower capacity. To be competitive country on global competition onward, every country is pressured and required to have a good mastery of technology. This pandemic has also forced us to utilize more frequent technology than used to be before. I do believe with good mastery of technology, our tourism could be moved to the next step and to meet our goal, which are to create quality tourism. Distinguished speakers, ladies and gentlemen, through this conference, I do encourage all parties to share and to exchange all the ideas to create a better future for our tourism. I would like to say congratulations to the committee for their dedication and tremendous work on organizing this wonderful event. I would also like to express my highest appreciation to the ITSA, to Pancasila University, and to all the committee who has been arranged this important event. It is so that our enthusiasm and then also our commitment to build tourism and as well as our confidence won't go down in the midst of COVID-19 pandemic. To conclude, I hope that everyone can enjoy the important conference. I believe with the spirit of cooperation and collaboration, it is not a mere fantasy for us to stronger, sustainable, and resilient tourism industry in the future. May peace, mercy, and blessing be upon us all. I thank you very much for your kind attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Thank you, Mrs. Giri, for your welcoming speech. To our distinguished guests, we are inviting you to take our picture together. For Mrs. Giri, please stay on the screen. And for Professor Wahono and Professor Edi Lutut, please stay on the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, before we move further to the next agenda, the committee would like to thank to our supporters of ITSA 2020, the Ministry of Tourism Creative Economy, Republic of Indonesia, Associate Bunda Mulia University, and media partner Venue Magazine.